Hi everybody, today rather than giving you a philosophy, I'd like to give you my humble opinions or a humble lecture about true Budo, Bushido, and pride. Unfortunately, in today's society, we have rings, sporting events, and stages where fierce competitors enter into a circle and they fight it out. For bragging rights, for ego, for arrogance, for fame, and some even fortune. Bushido, on the other hand, are codes of conduct. These are things that we value as a warrior. And true Budo means true martial arts. It doesn't mean true traditional stuff, but it means truly understanding the arts of war. Unfortunately, there are systems, traditional styles, that says you can only do it this way, and that's the only way. They rather have you stay inside the box, rather than making you think outside of the box. True martial arts should be understanding the art of war and many different variations of it. You should not be an inside-the-box thinker, and you should not think that the art of war is only one way. There are many fighting styles. There are many methods of war, and you should never limit yourself or close your mind to only one or two ways, but you should be really open and explore all variations of it, being a true Budo artist. What we should not do is take on one system or a couple systems and then call yourself a traditionalist and become very arrogant, have a giant ego, go on public forums and put other people down. This is not the true Budo way. A true martial artist would seek peace, but prepare himself for war. This is what a warrior should be. A warrior should be diligent and very skilled, but a warrior should also be very focused on why he is going to war. It is not for his ego. It is not for his national pride. It should not be anything other than to preserve life. In other words, to protect it and ensure survival. As a true martial artist, it's not about you being the best fighter. It's about understanding the best means to preserve your own life and those that you love. A warrior can war against many things. It could be mental aspects, spiritual aspects, and of course, physical aspects. But a true balanced warrior understands the ultimate goal is peace. Peace is required. A lot of people say peace can only be obtained after war. And the absence of war and chaos is true peace. Now let's get into what's truly a challenge or a fight. A true challenge isn't something where you go into a ring and it sets down rules. It doesn't have handicaps or advantages. Anybody bigger and stronger can call out a weaker, smaller individual, set rules, limitations, make it really biased so that they can bully or beat somebody up. This is not what a true challenge is. If you ask me what a true challenge is from a kanja perspective, and you think that with rules that by sparring will I only show my true skills, I'm sorry to disappoint you. This is a true challenge to me. It's when you and I go in to a jungle. Let's say somewhere out. Some place where they don't care. If you enter the jungle, you live or die. Without any weapons, two individuals enter this jungle, and by using the environment and your knowledge and skill, the person who comes out of that jungle alive would be a true challenge for a kanja. But if you think that with weight, speed, training, whatever advantage that a person has, and you can take somebody else without any weapons, without the use of environment, without the use of his mental knowledge, you put gloves on him and say it's a fair fight, or this is a true challenge, and you think that's the only way, I have a different opinion or outlook on that. Of course, a lot of cowards will probably fuel individuals, brainwash them, thinking this is the only fair way to fight, and instigate somebody even getting beaten to death. This is not a true challenge or a true fight. Like I said, if I was to enter into a jungle with nothing, and I don't care how big or how strong that individual was, but I was allowed to use the environment, my knowledge, make any weapon I want, and go in. And the only objective to the victory is who survives. That would be a fair challenge to me. On top of that, I would also make sure nobody stops him from beating the crap out of me for challenging me. At the same time, I'd make sure nobody stops me either. That would be a true challenge. But as a Christian, of course, this is not something that I could do. Nor do I encourage it. And I would discourage a lot of you cowards from taking an individual and fueling them, pumping them up so that they would actually go and do something like that. A coward would throw somebody to his grave and have probably no remorse, just for their own satisfaction or their own, it's the only way we could really know for sure type of excuse. I hope that a lot of you true Budo artists out there don't do things like that. All of you, God bless you, and we'll see you guys next time.